All right, it was the brave, courageous moment, wasn't it, that took the sporting world by storm?
Hi, everyone. It's Josh Cavallo here. I'm at my home here in Adelaide. There's something personal that I need to share with everyone. I'm a footballer and I'm gay.
Adelaide United's Josh Cavallo coming out to the public in what will go down in history as a first for the sport across the globe. And Josh joins us now from his home in Adelaide. Josh, so nice to see you this morning.
Hey, Josh.
Hi, guys. How are you going? It's a pleasure to be here.
We're so excited for you in a real genuine way. When we saw this yesterday, we both spoke about it. And just to see, I guess, what was relief on your face, but also just that smile. How did it feel?
Yeah, look, it's been very overwhelming the last 24 hours. My phone has been blowing up, so I'm trying to keep up as much as I can, but it's been absolutely crazy. Look, it's something that I've been wanting to do for a very long time now. It's been 6 years of my life that I've lived in darkness. Very sad time for myself, but I can't wipe the smile off my face at the moment. Like, I'm so happy and pleased with how everything's gone, and I'm so amazed with the support I'm receiving from everyone and everyone across the world. Like, it's absolutely amazing.
I mean, I just find it really interesting that we're sort of sitting here today and we're even having to have this conversation, that it's even an issue in 2021 for you to even have this angst about whether or not you could, or to keep it quiet for 6 years. Why did you feel for so long that you couldn't just say, this is who I am?
Yeah, definitely. Look, growing up, I didn't see someone that did something like this, so it was hard for me to picture a life where I could be myself and do what I love and play football. But I just want to show to future generations and to the people watching this on their TV, if there's someone going through a similar struggle that I did, that it's going to be okay. And look at the response I received, and I'm still the exact same person, and I'm loved for exactly who I am. So hopefully in 20, 30 years time, or even in the near future, this wouldn't even need to be a big deal. It's normal. So outside of football, being gay, it's quite normal. So why can't it be normal inside football?
You've got such a beautiful face and open eyes, and I would imagine for you, it would have been torture, you know, to an extent. Tell us about that night you decided enough was enough, and that you were going to, you couldn't live with it any longer as secret. Tell us about that.
Yeah, definitely. Look, as an athlete, the best thing you can do is get awards, and that was something I received on the awards night. I received the Rising Star Award, and I felt this sense of numbness, because I felt like I had to lie to my peers that whole time and act like someone I'm not, and it was eating me alive on the inside, and I didn't want to continue my life like that. I put my head on my pillow at night, and I was sad. I wasn't happy, and I didn't want to continue my life like that. This is more than just football for me. This is my personal life, and if I can help evolve the football game and just show that everyone's welcomed in the football community, that's all I'm looking to do.
I mean, there are going to be so many young kids coming through now where they're not going to have to go through the angst that you did for so many years because of what you've done in the past 24 hours. The response has been overwhelming, and it's been overwhelmingly positive. Did that surprise you?
Yeah, it definitely did surprise me. I didn't expect for big clubs and big stars to reach out to me, but it's been very overwhelming. It's a very exciting time for myself. So I wasn't expecting the support I got, and it just shows how much love there is in the world, and just makes me realise, why was I hiding myself for such a long time?
Do you know what's really interesting about you, apart from obviously this massive thing that you've done, but also that you've been playing with part of your mental application constricted and hidden and suppressed. And now I wonder what it means to you on the field as well to play unencumbered.
Definitely. Look, it's something that I've been waiting for, this moment, for 6 years. So it's like my freedom day. I can't wait to put my boots back on and get on the field and just play with a free mind. When I came out to my coaches 5-6 weeks ago, I already felt so much lighter, and I already felt so good. So I can only imagine what it's going to feel like now that my peers, my family, my friends, and everyone across the world has accepted me, so I'm really looking forward to playing this season.
What? Just one question, Josh, before we go. Why do gay men have such bloody great hair? It's really annoying.
It's a secret I can't tell. Sorry, mate.
Damn it!
It's going to have to live with what you got, my friend.
Just.
Hey, but, Josh, hey, look, well done.
That's it.
Well done,
mate. And thanks for coming on and talking about it this morning. You know, you've started a great conversation and you've changed lives, so always be really mindful of that. Well done, my friend.
What a beautiful guy. Good luck, Josh. Lovely to see
you,
mate.
Thank you so much. Thank you, guys.
What a big thing for a young man to do. And gorgeous. Gorgeous guy.
And hopefully, moving forward, as we said, it won't have to be a big thing for others
exactly.
coming through.
Why are you looking at my hair?
What
wondering
hair?
What goes into it. Oh, you didn't have to point that out. See, that's where you go too far. I'm very aware.
You look really good today. Did you take handsome pills?
You know what? You've
Did
got
you
lipstick
take handsome...
all over your teeth.
Probably do.
And
do
you
I?
Have had for 4 hours.
Oh, see? You deserve the hair comment.